Welcome everybody. We are discussing the chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. So this is the chapter 5 of class 11th biology. In our previous session, we have discussed about the root, its function and different modification of a root. Now today in this session, we'll discuss about the stem. So let us start our discussion. Let me first tell you what is stem. Stem is a part of plant which lies above from surface of soil. Okay. But general, this is the general feature I am telling. But there are some exceptions also, because the underground modification of stem is also there. Okay. But this is a general feature, that stem always grows above the surface of the soil. That means it is negatively geotropic. So its growth is negatively geotropic, means it is growing away from the surface of the earth. Okay, very very important, it is negatively geotropic, whereas root is positively geotropic. It grows towards the soil. Okay, then the stem has always, it has nodes, internodes, branches, leaves, flower buds are present. And from the nodes, the branch, leaves, flowers, fruits are developed. Okay, and I have already shown you what is node and what is internode in my previous session. So now, what is the function of stem? The stem facilitates conduction of water. See, once the root absorbs the mineral and water from the soil, then the stem conducts the water to different parts of it. Now, the water and mineral are carried to the leaves for the purpose of photosynthesis through the stem. And again, in the leaf, when the food is synthesized, then the food is distributed to different parts of the plant body through the stem. Okay. The next function of stem is that it produces and supports the leaves and reproductive structures like flower, fruits, etc. Okay. So it bears the leaves, it bears the flower, it bears the fruit. That means it supports the leaves, fruits and flower. And it also produces the leaves, fruits and flowers. Okay. And one of the most important feature of the stem is that they are developed from the plumule. So what is plumule? While discussing about the root, I have told you that the root is developed from the radicle. So radicle is a part of the embryo. Okay. So when the zygote develops into embryo, that embryo gradually differentiates into the radicle and the plumule, and the plumule is that part of the embryo from which the stem is developed. Very very important. So the stem is always developed from plumule, but root is developed from the radicle. Okay, now we'll discuss different forms of stem. These are different forms, not the modification. Don't confuse children. So, what are the different forms of stem? The first one is caudex. So, what is this stem? This type of stem is unbranched, erect, cylindrical, stout, and marked with scars of fallen leaves. Okay, I'll show you the picture. So, here you can see this is the example of caudex. So we can take coconut or palm. So here you can see this is the stem, and the stem is unbranched. So directly from the stem, the leaves are developed, and these are leaves. Don't think that these are the branches. So these are the leaves. And here you can see that the scars. So here I have shown you, highlighted here. These are the reason from where the leaves were developed once upon, but now they have fallen. So as the stem grows, the leaves falls down, or leaves are shedded off, and only the tuft of leaf is present at the terminal part of the stem. And such type of stem is called caudex. Okay. The next form of stem is thumb. So here the stem is jointed with solid nodes and the internodes are hollow. So let me show you the diagram. Here you can see this is the picture of a bamboo. So you can you know that this is the node from where the leaves and branches are developed, and here you can see this is the node, this is another node, and in between these two nodes there is a internode. Okay, so here the nodes are solid, but the internode is hollow. Okay, so this is in case of bamboo is the best example of a cum. So such type of stem is called cum. The next come to stem. So this type of stem is seen in some monocotyledonous plant, and here the aerial stem is absent. Aerial stem means what? The stem is not present above the ground level. So the stem is usually underground and it has a aerial branch only. It has a aerial branch. The main stem is underground, but the branch is aerial, that means present above the soil which bears the flower. So I'll show you the picture. So here you can see this is the onion plant. Okay. And you know that onion is the stem. That is the underground modification of the stem which bears the leaves. Okay. Now that is the main stem from where the branch is developed, and here you can see the branch bears a tuft of flower at its apex. So this is one of the branch which bears the flower. Okay. Am I clear? Now next come to other forms, that is prostrate or procumbent. Here the stem trails on the ground and lies prostrate. So I'll show you the picture. So here you can see this is prostrate, means horizontal. The stem, it is like a creeper. Okay. So it crawls on the ground. It grows horizontally on the ground. So such type of stem is called prostrate. Okay. The next type of stem is decumbent. So here the stem trails for some distance and then tends to rise at its apex. So this is in case of a tridax. So here you can see, so the stem is prostrate up to certain distance, and after that the stem rises and it bears the leaves and flowers. Okay, so this is the elongated part, that is erect part of the stem which bears the stem and flower, and this portion is the prostrate plant. So such type of stem is called decumbent. Okay. Then the next type is diffuse. When the branch of the stem are spread out in all direction on the ground, then that is called diffuse. So see, here I have given you the example of euphorbia. So here the stem is trailing on the surface of the ground, but here you can see it is profusely branched. So a number of branches, and these branches are spreaded in all direction. Okay, such type of stem are called diffuse. The next type of stem is climbers. So here the stem attach themselves to nearby object by means of some special device like hooks. Okay, as in case of bougainvillea. So all of you have seen the bougainvillea. So I am giving you the example of bougainvillea. So here you can see in bougainvillea, this is the stem and the branch and stem. So here you can see some hook-like structures. Okay, the spine or hook-like structures. Here I am showing you. The hook or spine-like structures are there, which helps the plant to climb up the support. Okay. So, such type of stem, generally which are weak. So the all these stems are weak. Okay, so that's why they're trailing on the surface of the ground. But here it is stronger than the other type of stems, but weaker. As a whole, it is a weak stem. So that's why it always tend to climb up some support with the help of its hook-like structures or the spine, you can say. So such type of stem are called your thymbers. Okay, that is seen in case of bougainvillea. Now see, we'll discuss the different modification of the stem. As we have discussed in case of root, other than performing their normal function, they perform some other special function. Okay, other than performing the general function, the stem also performs some specific function, and because of which they are modified. Okay, and that is called stem modification. So here are the summary of the stem modification. So the stem modification are basically of three types, that is aerial modification, subaerial modification, underground modification. Let me first tell you what is aerial modification. So aerial modification means here the stem is totally present on the surface of the ground. Okay, so it is exposed, the all part of the stem is exposed to air, that's why it is aerial. Then subaerial means some portion of the stem is underground, whereas some other part of the stem, main stem, I'm talking about the main stem, is above the soil level or the ground level. Okay, so aerial means the main stem is completely above the ground level. Subaerial means the part of the stem is below the ground and some part of the stem is above the ground. And underground modification means the whole stem, the main stem, is completely under the ground. Now, what are the aerial modifications? Again, this aerial modification, some of the aerial modification we have already discussed under the forms of stems. They are the creepers, trailers, okay, and climbers. So, we have already discussed the procumbents, decumbents, and diffuse. Then here, now we'll discuss the climbers, that is root climbers, stem climbers, tendril climbers, and hook climbers. Hook climber we have discussed, that is one of the climber, so lianas. Okay, so only few of them are there in your syllabus, so that only we'll discuss. Then now coming to the subaerial modification, they are runner, stolon, sucker, offset. And under underground modification, the stems are bulb, corm, rhizome, and tube. Now let us first discuss the aerial modification of stem. So what are the aerial modification? That is stem tendril. So here, what is tendril? The tendril is a coiled structure which usually helps in climbing of the support. So here in the stem, the axillary bud means the bud of the stem that develops from the main stem forms a coiled structure that is called tendril. And this tendril is formed in place of branches. And what is the function of this climbing tendrils? They help the main stem to climb up the support because the stem is weak. So this is seen in case of grapevines, passiflora, cucumber, pumpkin, watermelon. Okay, I'll show you the picture. So here you can see this is the stem tendril. And this is stem tendril, you can see this is the main stem. And then this is the branch. In place of branch, the branch is there, the leaf is there. But in spite of that, some branch are converted into tendril, that is coiled structure, that is called tendril, which helps the plant to climb up the support. Okay? Now, the next type of modification is phylloclade. So, this type of modification, in this type of stem modification, the stem is flat, fleshy, and green leaf-like structure. Okay, and it is seen in case of your desert plant or xerophytic plant. And here, why such modification of stem is there? To carry out the photosynthesis. So, when the stem is flattened and fleshy and green, it contains enough chlorophyll so that it can synthesize enough food. But here, the leaves are modified into spines. So, why the leaves are modified into spines? Because if the leaves will be there, normal leaves will be there in the desert plant, then the transpiration rate will be more. So, in order to prevent the excess loss of water through transpiration, the leaves are modified into spines. So, all of you have seen this plant, that is your opuntia. Okay, so here you can see this is opuntia. So, here this green part is not the leaf, this is the stem. So, the stem is flat. Fleshy structure, this is called phylloclade. And here you can see these are the spines, and the spines are the leaves. These are the modified leaves. Leaves are modified into leaves, spines, and they provide protection as well as reduce the rate of transpiration or water loss. Then the next type is prickle and hooks. So this is seen in case of rose. So, in rose, you all have observed this plant. So, I have not given the diagram here. So, this hook or spine like structures, which are usually called hook here in this case, they develop exogenously. Exogenously means outermost layer of the stem. So, what is the outermost layer of the stem? Epidermis. Outermost layer of any part of the plant is the epidermis. So, these prickles or hooks that is present in rows are developed from the epidermis, and they are present at the nodes or internodes. They may be present at the nodes and internodes. Okay. And they also help the plant to climb up the support. So, here very important is that these prickles and hooks are exogenous. So, why I am giving stress upon this term? Because next we will discuss about the thorn, which is endogenous. Thorn is also a spine-like structure, a big spine-like structure. So, this is also a spine-like structure. But why two different names? Because one is exogenous, the prickle or hook is exogenous, and the stem thorn is endogenous. Okay. The next type of modification, aerial modification, is stem thorn. So, it develops from the axillary buds or terminal bud of the stem. Terminal bud means the bud that is present at the terminal part of the stem or apex of the stem. Okay. And this thorn bears leaves, flowers. It may also bear leaves and flowers. That means it is you can consider it as one of the branch of the stem, but it is spine like. Okay. So, what is the difference between hook and the thorn? The thorn is endogenous and it can develop terminally also, but the hook can develop axillary, and it is developed at the nodes and internodes. Which one? Hooks. Hooks can develop at the node and internode, but the thorn can develop only at the node or in the position of the terminal bud. So, I have already shown you the picture of bougainvillea. Okay. So, let me show you once again. So, this is in bougainvillea. You can see these are the thorns. Okay. These are thorns. The next is cladode. So, here the green stem is the main stem is of limited growth, but it has only one or two internodes. Okay, so this is, you can see this is the modified form of phylloclade. I'll show you that this is the diagram of asparagus. So in asparagus you can see the main stem is it is a flat like the phylloclade, and it is green in color, and the branches are only few. Okay, so it is having only one or two nodes. So here you can see this is one node, this is one node. So only two nodes are present on the main stem, and leaves are very much reduced in their size to reduce the rate of transpiration. Okay, so here also the stem which is green in color, the branch which is green in color performs the photosynthesis. So we can say the phylloclade with only one internode is called cladode. Okay, very very important, the phylloclade with only one internode is called cladode, and the example is asparagus. Okay, so next we'll discuss about the subaerial modification of stem. So these are the subaerial modifications are runner, stolon, sucker and offset. So in runner, the stem grows and spreads on the surface of the soil. Okay, because the name itself indicates that there runs on the surface of the soil, and the roots are developed at lower side and leaves from the upper side from the node. So the very common example is your dub grass, that is Cynodon and Oxalis. I'll show you the picture. Here you can see the stem is very weak and it grows prostrate or horizontally on the surface of the ground. But what do you see at the node? At the node, below the, that is the lower part of the node is developing the root. So, what is the nature of this root? This root is taproot or adventitious root. Definitely, it is adventitious root because it is developed from the node, not from the radical. And from the upper side of the node, the leaves are developed. Okay. So, this is a type of stem, weak stem, which grows horizontally on the surface of the ground, and from the upper part of the node, the leaves are developed, and from the lower parts of the node, the adventitious roots are developed. Then the next type of subaerial modification is stolon. Okay, one more thing I have forgot to tell you. So, why it is called subaerial? Because this nodal region, this node of the stem is underground, but rest of the portion of the stem is present above the ground. Okay, so that's why they are called, because some portion of the stem, main stem is underground and some portion is present above the ground. That's why they are subaerial. Okay. Now see stolon. So here, the branches are very small and stem is condensed. Stem is also condensed, and more often it is swollen, and it grows in all direction. After some time of growth, their apical region comes out from the soil, as in case of jasmine. So jasmine plant, all of you have seen. So here you can see this is the stolon. So here you can see this portion. So, what is the difference between runner and the stolon? In runner, the main stem, the nodal part is above the soil and rest of the part is below the soil. But here it is curved in this way, like curved like this, so that the main stem, the nodal part of the main stem is underground and the other part of the stem is present above the ground. And these are the branches, and here the stem is reduced, and it is the branches are spreaded in all directions. So here you can see this is the stem. This portion is also a stem. This is a portion of stem. So some portion of the stem is underground and some portion of the stem is above the ground. That's why it is subaerial. Okay. So from the picture you can see what is the difference between these two. So here also the branches and the leaves are developed from the upper part of the node, and from lower part of the stem the roots are developed. Okay, here you can see, but the difference is the shape of the stem. Okay, so here this portion is underground, but here this portion is underground. Okay, nodal portion is underground. Then next comes to sucker. So here the main stem grows in the soil, but branches develop from the nodes above the soil and as well as below the soil. So it is seen in case of chrysanthemum. I'll show you the picture. So here you can see the stem. This is the stem. This is suppose the main stem. So the main stem grows longitudinally erect on the soil, but some portion of the stem is underground, and from that underground part the branches, some of the branches are developed, and those branches are containing the scale leaves, that is brown scale leaf. Because that portion is underground, so no need of carrying out the photosynthesis, because they are not receiving the light. So that's why those leaves present on those underground branches are brown in color, and they are known as brown scale leaves. So here you can see this is the underground portion of the stem. Okay, so only this, up to this it is underground, and from here it is present above the ground. So underground portion of the stem is having the brown scale leaves, okay, which cannot perform the photosynthesis, and such type of stem is called sucker. The underground portion is called sucker. The next subaerial modification is offset. So here the stem is shorter and thicker, and is found in aquatic plant, and this from its node tuft of leaves are growing. Okay, and this stem usually grows horizontally. So here you can see all these types of stems are growing horizontally except the sucker, where the branches are developing erect. So here in offset also you can see that the stem is horizontal, but it is very short, and it is seen in case of aquatic plants, Eikornia, water hyacinth. All of you have seen this plant. This is a weed. Okay, this is an aquatic weed. Within a short period of time, it covers the whole water body. That's why it is called Terror of Bengal. Okay, so here you can see the stem is this portion of the stem which is present below the surface of water, that is called offset. And this is the node, and this is the node, and from the nodal region you can see the tuft of leaves are developed on the upper side of the node, and from the lower side of the node the roots are developed. Okay, now we'll discuss the underground modification of stem. The underground modifications are tuber, rhizome, corm and bulb. So what is tuber? Here the stem, so these underground modifications are mainly meant for the storage of food. Okay, but they bear all the characteristics of the stem, like presence of node, internodes, buds, branches, everything are present. That's why they are known as stem, not root, even though they are underground. So first one is tuber. Tuber, it is irregularly shaped swollen stem, and the tip of the branch becomes swollen in the soil, and eyes are found on them, which are auxiliary buds and covered with scale leaves. I'll show you the pictures. So here you can see this is the tuber potato. Okay, so this is not a fruit, or this is not a root. This is the underground stem, and here you can see this is the region that is called eye. The nodal regions are called eye, from where the buds are developed. So here you can see the axillary buds are developed. So this is the, you can it can be identified as the node. And besides that, in potato the brown scale leaves are there, because it is underground, so there is no fleshy and healthy green leaves are there, but the leaves are modified into scale like brown color structure, So they don't perform the photosynthesis. But these underground structure performs the storage of food, and it is also meant for vegetative propagation. How it helps in vegetative propagation? See, here the bud has been developed. If you cut this eye portion, and if you want to grow a new plant, then you can grow from this. So this is the only reproductive part in case of tuber. So the tuber, stem tuber, is having the reproductive part. The leaves, the nodes and internodes are there. That's why it is a stem. Then the next one is rhizome. So the rhizome is also meant for storage of food and vegetative propagation, means vegetative reproduction. So here the stem is fleshy, horizontally found below the soil, and small nodes and internodes are found, which are covered by scaly leaves. Let me show you. So here this is the ginger. This is the diagram of ginger. This stem is called rhizome. Here the stem grows horizontally. So this is the stem. It grows horizontally. It has branch. So this is the node. And the branch develops the leaves. So only the leaves are present above the ground. So this portion only present above the ground, and rest, the whole stem is present below the ground. And it develops a number of adventitious roots from its nodes. So here you can see these are the nodes from where the roots are developed. So these are the adventitious roots. And here you can see these are the buds which has been developed into the, that is, aerial shoot, that is leaves. Okay. And you can see the scaly leaves. The nodes are covered by the brown scaly leaves. Okay. And only those leaves which are present above the ground are green in color, and they perform the photosynthesis. So one more thing I'll tell you, children, in case of tuber. In tuber, the branches of the stem are present above the ground, and which can bear the normal leaf, and they perform the normal function of the leaf. Now next is corm. So it is a condensed structure which grows vertically under the soil surface. See, rhizome grows horizontally and corm develops vertically. Okay, and it is highly swollen and vertical stem. So here you can see this is a corm. You can say it is a colocasia, and here you can see this is the stem, underground stem. Here the buds are developed. Okay, and it is covered with the scale leaves. Brown scale leaves are there, and these are the branches. Okay, and from the branches are developed from the node, and from the node you can see the leaves are there. And as a whole, this is a elongated structure, and it grows elongated. Okay, it is grows longitudinally. That's why it is a elongated structure. So this is the difference between corm and rhizome. Then the next one is bulb. So here the stem has a disc-like structure, and the stem is present at the center, which is surrounded by numerous fleshy scale leaves, and the roots are developed from its base. Okay, so here I'll show you the picture of onion. So at the center of onion, you might have observed one erect structure is present, hard structure is present. That is actually the main stem. Okay, and only the branch is present above the soil, which bears a tuft of flowers, as I have told you earlier. So here this portion is the main stem or main shoot, and at the center the stem is present, which is surrounded by the fleshy leaves. So fleshy leaves are ultimately covered by the scale leaves. Okay, and they are non-green leaves because they are underground. The fleshy leaves stores the food, and you can see here this is the base of the stem. From the basal part of the stem, a tuft of adventitious roots are developed. Okay, so one more thing I want to tell you here, the bulbs are of two types. One is scaly and other is imbricate. So You might have observed that in garlic, that it is imbricate type. That means the leaves are more fleshy and they are arranged in a hole. Okay, so that is called imbricate type of a bulb. But in case of onion, it is tunicate. That means here they are present, the leaves are present one above the other. Okay, but in garlic they are present in different hole. Okay, so these are the different modification of the stem, and these modifications are to perform the specific functions, not the general functions. Okay, so I hope all the modifications of stems and their functions are very much clear to you. So in our next session we'll discuss the leaf. Okay, thank you for watching the video till end. Thank you once again.